Good evening, Gungeoners. Welcome back to Enter the Gungeon. This is a very special episode because, once again, I have deleted my commentary before I managed to edit for the episode. As a result, I have a very special guest with me today. Please introduce yourself.
What's up, Mother Gunners? It's me, Skippy.
Skippy Granola is a, I guess I'd call you one of my protégés for Enter the Gungeon.
Oh, yes, actually, Scruffy Sensei, it is because of you that I was able to destroy the Lich.
Yeah, so Skippy is one of the people who has, I don't know if you picked up Gungeon because of me, but you have. You've had success because of me, so I'm happy with this.
Absolutely. I saw episode 1, and I thought, well, this game looks fun. And if a dipshit like Scruffy could be successful...
No, tell me how you really feel.
Oh, I mean, go Minasai, Scruffy Sensei.
So, this is a continuation of the last episode where it was a cursed run, but I died on floor 2.
Yep, I see that you prayed at the red shirt shrine.
Yeah, so once you complete all 4 paths, you have the option of praying at the initial shrine, and that will immediately bring you up to 9 curse.
I believe 9... you can pray at it with any character of whom you've killed the past. You don't have to destroy all 4.
I think you're right, actually. I haven't tested it, so I couldn't tell you for sure.
So kill one past, kids, and go curse
go
run.
Nuts.
Go curse forever.
Get crazy.
Curse is tight as hell, man. More ammo drops, more casings, flipping.
See, that's one of the things.
Curse bullets.
That's one of the things that confuses me because I know that. So normally, curse will reduce your chances for item drops.
Easy.
It is a mathematical computation, in that every room you complete has a certain percentage plus coolness minus curse of dropping an item. And every room that you do not receive a drop, it will increase for the next room. So it's one of those things that really confused me on the last run is that I got all sorts of ammo drops.
Mm-hmm.
But I also had a lot of curse and not that much coolness. So I was really confused.
Come on, you sucker. You breathing? No, you ain't.
Yeah, no. So that's one of the things that you have to look out for on cursed runs is mimics. That is absolutely a thing, because I mentioned this in the last video, which has not been published yet. I have 3 goals for this run. One of them is to complete a cursed run. By complete a cursed run, I mean finish Bullet Hell. I've done that approximately once.
Oh, please tell me you had a jam glitch.
Well, you'll find out. That's only like an hour away from now.
Oh, I'm rubbing my cheeks in glee.
So, in my entire time of playing the game, as far as praying from the that statue at the beginning of the room to the very end of Bullet Hell, I've done that once. And that's because a jam run is really freaking hard.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it sucks at first, and then it continues really sucking. And then somehow, it gets even worse.
Jam runs are really hard, that's all I'm saying. So I had a moment in this exact kind of room, this exact layout, where I got trapped in the top left, and I took a hit from a jammed enemy. Now, I know I've mentioned it before, but jammed enemies, you see those dark red bullets? If you're taking a armor hit, they take a normal hit, same as ever. If you're taking a health hit, they take one full heart instead of a half heart. Jammed enemies.
Look how many casings you're getting! Oh my god!
But that's the upside. Jammed enemies are freaking loaded with casings. They are made of casings. So this is where the trade-off comes in. Like, this is... If you're going to try and unlock your elevator shortcuts, I know I've talked to a few people who have had actually a lot of trouble unlocking floors past floor 4 because the hollow is actually a pretty tough floor. Don't get me wrong, it's a pretty tough floor.
Oh yeah.
But there are people who have not finished the hollow, but at the same time, they have unlocked the elevator up to floor 3. And at this point in the LP, this video, I will be unlocking floor 2 on the elevator. On the last episode, I did another jam run and I died on floor 2. That's, you know, hashtag spoilers for Skippy, who hasn't seen it yet, but I haven't published it yet, so whatever.
Oh, peeking behind the curtain.
Yeah, you know, peeking behind the curtain. I will publish that before this video, so Skippy. On the last video, I did another jam run. I went to the Oubliette, I had 3 keys and a whole bunch of casings, and I died on the floor.
Oh, yeah, that'll happen. That'll happen.
It happens. Like, it's one of those things I wish I could say that I'm like, I'm so good at this game that I never died at anything ever, but it's not true. Like, despite how easy I make this game look, it's really not.
No, absolutely not. I'd like to take this opportunity to apologize to anyone who has been watching my Gungeon streams, because I have been sucking monstrous amounts of shit.
So I should mention that Professor Goopton here, normally he speaks in an alien language. When you bite the sponge, you can understand what he's saying. Just...
No way!
Yeah, no. If you own the sponge, you can understand Professor Goopton.
Maybe it's because his words are so gloopy that you need the sponge to soak up the excess gloop.
That's entirely a possibility. Have you dealt with the sponge before?
No, I've, oh, fuck.
Yeah. Dual jammed bosses, are you ready for this shit?
Nice!
So the sponge, the special ability of the sponge, it removes all creep next to you. Like, it actively removes creep, so poison and fire, it's almost impossible to be damaged by those while you own the sponge.
Yeah, it's a passive
that just erases gloopies. It's great. So in my previous run, I also encountered the Trigger Twins, and Smiles was jammed while Shades was normal. So I killed Smiles first, and then I dealt with the normal enraged Shades. Normally my method is to deal with Smiles enraged. But since they're both enraged, well, no winning here. But, hey,
yeah,
still got that master round.
And a gold casing!
And a gold casing. So this is something I didn't realize until, like, the second floor. Gold casings are really freaking good. Gold casings are 50 casings. Oh my god.
50 buckaroonies. So much.
50 buckazoids are freaking amazing. You have no idea. I also got the Phoenix, which is not a very good weapon. I'll be honest with you.
I don't like the Bahoenix at all.
Yeah, so the Phoenix, its big selling point is that if you're close enough to an enemy, it shoots out like a fire plume, and that plume of fire can set enemies on fire. It's not very good otherwise. I wouldn't use it if I was you.
That's where 90% of the damage comes from. It's such a booby prize, too.
It really is. So at this point, I'm sitting here thinking. So the last video, I finally got the casings and the keys necessary to help out the tanker on the elevator repair. But now I need 10 Hmon credits to feed to him to finish off the elevator. Right now I'm at 7. Now if I finish the boss on this floor, I will probably have 7, and then I can finally finish off the elevator here and be good to go. So that's one of my goals for this floor. Don't get me wrong, one of my primary goals is to finish a cursed run, which is not going well so far, let me tell you.
Oh, jeez. Come on. I mean, okay, so you don't have a lot of super tight guns.
I really don't. I've got the RPG, and I've got the frickin' Phoenix. It's a bad go.
you're in pretty good shape health wise.
No, you're right. I have not taken a single hit yet, so it could be worse.
You got the eye of the tiger, kid. You're a killer. You're a wrecking machine. You're gonna eat lightning and crap thunder.
I've got the thrill of the fight. I'm gonna eat lightning and crap thunder. You're not wrong. I'm gonna eat red, yellow, and blue and crap a rainbow.
That's right. Ooh. Ooh. Ooh.
So one of the items I got from that brown chest was a backpack, so now I can carry two active items. So now the supply drop will come with me, and I also have double vision. And double vision is a pretty good brown chest item. Double vision is a, well, essentially you take a hit in accuracy in exchange for two bullets for the price of one.
Yeah, I will hold, and I will defend to the death the fact that if you know that a brown chest is going to be a passive, it is definitely worth opening.
You know, and that's one of the things that I really haven't mentioned yet, is that if you know for a fact that a brown chest is going to be a passive item as compared to a gun or even an active item, brown chests are worth opening. That's a thing. You know, it's not one of those things I've given very much interest to because, well, my basic mantra is don't open a brown chest if it requires a key. But I will say that there are many brown chest either passive or active items that are worth using. And as of the supply drop update, there is at least one gun that is very worth using for a brown chest. Skippy's not a fan of it. I haven't unlocked it in the LP yet.
I'm not convinced yet, but I'm open-minded.
So you did not you didn't watch any of Kalen Zombie's 24-hour stream for Planned Parenthood, did you?
Nah, afraid not. I was.
That's fine. Hey, it's absolutely fine. I'm saying. So I was playing in my main file for that, where I've unlocked everything, and I had the particular item I'm thinking of unlocked. I used that for the entirety of Bullet Hell, and I took very little damage.
See, my problem with said item is...
Well, you know, let's go ahead and reveal it. The item is Casey. It is a bat. It's a melee weapon. It's amazing.
It's a reference to the famous Americana poem,
Casey at the
Bat.
It is. Yeah.
But yeah, it's a shit wrecker. It does like 100 damage at close range.
It does a lot of damage.
It's a charge weapon.
Yeah.
So you can't swing it like crazy.
You can't swing it like nuts. It does require a charge up before you can swing it.
And you can also hit projectiles back, so I mean, on paper, it's great, but in practice, it's one of those ones that you gotta have some skill.
I cannot wait until I get Casey in the LP, because I am going to use that fucker like nobody's business. I am going to wreck some shit. Oh, I can't wait!
I will be proved wrong, I'm sure. And then I'm gonna start using Casey, and then I'm gonna kill the Lich again, and then I'm gonna be like, well, I guess my secret is I need to watch Scruffy Sensei do it first.
Yeah, so my trick with Casey is one of the items I had was I had the Cog of Battle, which is the active reload weapon. So Casey is a one-shot weapon. So every time you reload it, you have to actually reload. So if I do the active reload, I gain more damage from it. Casey is also a one-shot weapon. So if you have something like the Alpha Bullets or Omega Bullets, it will gain more damage. Basically what I'm saying is, I had a good run with Casey, don't get me wrong, but it was a really good run with Casey. Oh, I'm so happy with it.
here's something I'm curious about.
Okay.
Alright, so there's a passive item called the Quick Draw Holster.
Okay. The quick draw holster is when you reload, it shoots out ammo of the current gun.
It shoots a free bullet.
Yeah, shoots a free bullet. What's up?
So, what I'm wondering is, if you reload with Casey, does it give you a free swing?
So, I'm not 100% positive on that. What I think happens, as another part of the supply drop, there was an item added called flak bullets. Apparently, if you use Casey with flak bullets, it shoots out small little projectiles out of Casey.
Okay.
Like, normally Casey is not a projectile weapon at all, don't get me wrong, I'm not denying that.
Yeah.
But it's a thing. So, ooh, black chest, do you see this?
Oh! Oh!
Like, I have to sit here and look at it for a minute, is it a mimic? No, it's not. And this is this is a thing that you get for killing the Lich, the Gungeon Blueprint. So, once in a while, you may notice that there are... the shopkeeper sells maps. The Gungeon Blueprint basically acts as a free map for every single floor. So, anytime there is a secret room, you can see it in the gray there on the left. You'll know where this stuff is. And in fact, you know, all those bullet sharks revealed it with that cracked wall. But, you know, with me being on a cursed run, I have to watch every single chest and make sure it's not a mimic. I really do.
Yeah, they can surprise
they
you.
They really can. Like, I know on the video before, on two videos before this, like, I was opening a brown chest and I'm like, hold on, you're a mimic. Oh my god, it's a mimic!
Here's something worse. So one of the rewards you can get out of Fur Rifle and the Gray Mauser is a Mimic Tooth necklace.
Yes.
Which guarantees that every chest is going to be a mimic, which means you don't need to spend keys.
But here's the counterpoint to that is the Mimic Tooth necklace can have a particular combination with the Ring of Mimic Friendship.
Yes.
So, you could guarantee that every single chest you encounter is a mimic, but at the same time, you could also guarantee that every mimic you encounter will just be a free chest.
Just open up. Be like, reach inside me, friend.
Exactly.
Reach inside me, friend Gungeoneer. Anyway, here's the stupidity of my story. So I had this, and I was constantly surprised when chests turned out to be mimics. I'm like, I knew I had this, and I'm like, I'm just gonna open this.
Wink. Especially when it looks like it's locked. That's the best use of your keys.
Oh, like, yeah, I'm just like, son of a biscuit.
Really, that's what makes mimics the worst, is that if they're locked, and if they're still mimics, they will eat your key and then still shoot at you.
Mimics are trash.
Mimics are the worst. Mimics are jerks.
Hashtag kill all mimics.
Hashtag kill all mimics. That is an accurate statement. So the shot bow is the best weapon I have for boss killing. Then I realized, wait a minute, I also have double vision. This is going to be good. Like, don't get me wrong, the shot bow is not accurate to begin with. That's not the problem. But if you can shoot at, like, twice as many things just for the price of nothing, and you don't have to be exactly accurate, ooh, you can do so much damage.
It's so good on big bosses.
It really is. The shot bow is very good on big bosses. It's not very good for room clearing, but hey, you know. That's number two with the master rounds going on.
And the Heart of Ice.
Yeah, so Heart of Ice gives you a heart, just period dot. That's actually a black chest item. It's a heart container, and also whenever you take damage, it spouts out ice projectiles, which I think can freeze guys. I'm not positive on that. I'm pretty sure, but I'm not positive. But now, I finally have 10 Hmon credits, so let's go and talk to the Tinker. And now, I have finally finished the second floor elevator.
So good.
Oh, yes. So next time, on the next video, I will go to the Reach, and I'll talk to this guy, and he'll say, man, you're so freaking great. You gave me this stuff. Let's go ahead and give you an item, and meet me on floor 3, and then I will ask you for even more stuff.
And then more stuff, because...
Yeah, no.
I mean, he's a tinker, not a scrounger.
It gets rude. Like, I think at the floor 4 or floor 5, he asks you for 6 pieces of junk.
It's just for... Well, he doesn't ask you for junk, he asks you for lunch.
He asks you for lunch. That's what gets technical, yes. He asks you for lunch. But, you know,
hey, the sponge.
Let's be fair, the junk looks like a lunch bag. Yeah?
The junk looks like my lunch every day at the office.
It's junky. Hashtag just junk things.
Just junky lunch.
Junky lunch.
I'd like one junky lunch, please.
I would love one junky lunch. That would be great.
Oh, man. I'm gonna open a junkie lunch counter.
So yeah, I'm looking around here and I'm seeing, well, there's two green chests. This is good. I also see a red chest right there, the secret room. And I also see the Gunsling King. And the Gunsling King is my favorite guy because most of the time this is a terrible room. Do you see this?
Oh, gross!
Do you?
Gross.
Yes! So, I deleted my commentary accidentally, but I'm pretty sure gross was my exact commentary for this room.
Yeah. That's not nice.
No, it is the worst.
I mean, honestly, that Jamomancer might as well have just stayed home.
Yeah, no.
Today.
The Jamomancer had nothing to do in this room because there were three jammed enemies, and also a Jamomancer who was just there for gee whiz.
Just like, hey, man. I'm jamming up.
We jamming. I just want to be jamming with you.
Oh, I'm jamming out.
That Jamomancer was Bob Marley. So there's me showing off the sponge, and that it also clears out fire creep. The sponge is a really good thing. If you can pick up the sponge for cheap, yeah, the sponge is really good. Also, there's me taking hits from this jammed coal.
Yeah, thank goodness you had armor.
Yeah. I really hate jammed enemies because they do they do a full heart of damage. They're bad. I really don't like jammed enemies. They're terrible. I hate them. But so my goal here, I don't have any keys yet. So obviously I need to get to the store before I explore too many rooms. And guarantee that I can get at least one key, right?
Yeah,
that's one of the other things that I've pointed out in the LP. If you don't pick up a key before you get to the store, you're guaranteed to get at least one key. It's an important thing.
So I gotta be letting mimics anyway.
Yeah. Funny you should mention that, but we'll get there.
Oh boy, I'm hoping that we see a black chest mimic. Those are nice.
Unfortunately, no. There are no. There's no mimics that are greater than green mimics. But let me tell you.
In this run, at least.
At this run, yes. But red or black mimics, they are the worst. I hate them with so much passion.
Don't fight them inside the treasure room. That's my free advice to you. Drag them out into a bigger space.
Red and black mimics will destroy you. They are
so
angry
rude.
Men. So I figure, well, I've got all these casings. I might as well use it, right?
Oh, table tech sight, huh?
So whenever you, at this point, whenever you flip a table, it slows down time, and also increases the bullets that you fire as well. As you can see right there.
Look, two. Oh.
I think it increases them by times three. So you can
something like that.
You can actually shoot out a lot of bullets. And actually, I find quite a bit of use out of it before too long. Table tech sight is one of those things that you may not think of using too much, but it has its moments. Like, I mean, as I said earlier, the Phoenix is not a very good weapon. You can see here I'm using this guy. It's not great. Oh, hey, a selfie.
You don't just fire for days. Oh, a new friend!
Totally a new friend. For sure.
Or
maybe an old friend. Who knows?
Maybe an old friend who you were a complete cock to.
That is just not fair. I happened to accidentally, you know, put my foot next to that helmet and it just totally tumbled down.
Yeah, sure thing, Butterfeet.
So this next room is a challenge for don't take any damage. Now, tell me if you can find what is wrong about this room.
Oh, please.
I'll wait. You got time. You really do have time.
Wait, what? The challenge is don't take any damage?
Mm-hmm. Challenge is don't take any damage.
took damage right there. And it didn't say fail.
Yeah.
Did you break the Gunsling King? Wait! The challenge room wasn't that hallway, was it?
No, the challenge room was that room that I took damage in.
Okay, you know what? Gunsling King, that's... he's drunk, that's his problem. He's just, he's full of regal sherry.
Hey,
just,
look at this freaking mimic. It's another jammed mimic, even freaking better.
Oh, sick! Why are you fighting him in that room?
Because...
Who are you trying to impress?
Nobody. I'm just... I hate myself.
Oh my goodness.
So now I have the RPG and the stinger.
Huh.
Is this a mimic?
Shit, if only you could duct tape those together.
No, it's not a mimic. It's staying still.
Oh, well.
Oh, so now I have the mailbox so I can glitter enemies. Glitter bomb enemies.
I'm 100% on board with that.
Yes, it is a good thing to do to enemies. Look.
There's nothing more majestic than a glitter bombed high dragon. Motherfucker seriously looks like something out of a Queen video. It's amazing.
It's a thing. There's a specific achievement for killing a boss while he is glitter bombed. And the only way you can achieve that is with the mailbox. It's great.
That's right. The achievement is called Day Ruiner because glitter bombing, folks, is really fun. It's not puerile at all.
It's really fun. So you can see here, I'm now on floor 2, this is, and I'm at 3 hearts. And here's another jammed mimic.
Oh, son of a biscuit!
Oh, my favorite. This is the best.
Just lie down. Lie down, you poorly built scum sucker.
Like, this is the worst part of this run, is that not only do I have to deal with mimics, I have to deal with jammed mimics.
It's a good life. Oh, hey, friend.
Hey, it's the ledge goblin. I don't know why you did that, but please don't do it again. Can you guess what I'm probably going to do at the start of next run?
You really got to watch where you put your feet.
I'm going to be careful, don't get me wrong. It's just... Well...
You're going to carefully maintain eye contact as you boot that piece of shit helmet back into the Gungeon.
Go get it! Pick that up, goblin!
And see, the most dickish part is that there's still at least one more person I have to unlock. Every time you kick down the ledge goblin's helmet, there's at least one more person that there's left to unlock. And I am not unlocking that person because I'm the ledge goblin instead.
I don't want to say that goblins have a high risk of recidivism, but it's interesting how she ends up in prison all the time.
You know, so here's the thing: is maybe it's just the helmet that is the that's the real enemy here. Just mean the the ledge goblin.
So the ledge goblin's helmet is like Walter White's hat.
Yeah.
In Breaking Bad.
Yeah, no. So the ledge goblin by itself, ledge goblin is a fine person. She's good. But it's the helmet that always wanted to inside the cell.
I gotcha. And she doesn't think to wedge the door.
No, the helmet is the bad boy.
Helmets are basically the new fedora for signaling that somebody is bad news. Somebody's wearing a motorbike helmet.
Hashtag just helmet things.
That's right.
So yeah. The item I picked up, ballistic boots, they increase your movement speed. Ballistic boots are a pretty good item. I like them.
More speed is fantastic.
More speed is always good. Are you ready for a jammed cannon Balrog?
Oh, 100%! Whoa!
I took a hit.
Oh, he looks so threatening.
I'm the worst. Would you...
Cannon Balrog cheats, so
cannon Balrog
no jury in the
is
world
a jerk.
Convict you.
And the worst part is... if I didn't take that single hit, that particular one, I would have had an all master rounds run.
No way.
No, I am spoiling that ahead of time. If I didn't take that one hit, this would have been all master rounds.
The only time I was ever able to do that was on a clone run.
Yeah, no, it's a thing. Clone runs are great. I have not encountered the clone. I have not encountered the clone in the LP yet. But clones are pretty amazing.
The clone was the only reason that I was able to kill the Lich. I mean, in addition to your brilliant tutelage. But yeah, it was a clone.
Whenever I encounter the clone, if I happen to need the clone, here's a nice weapon, by the way, a Raiden Coil.
Oh! That one's weird.
It is a weird weapon. I'll explain it on the next floor. But yeah. So, if I encounter a clone run and I actually need the clone when I have it, I'll probably split it up into two videos, because the clone is a very special item. So, Raiden Coil.
Look.
It's,
oh, so cool.
It's based on the video game, Raiden, which is an old-school top-down shooter. It's
top-down shmup.
Yeah, it's a top-down shmup. It's based on on the purple weapon from Raiden, which homes in on every single enemy in the room. See, the problem with that is that the Raiden Coil doesn't do very much damage.
Yeah.
If this was a normal run, this weapon would be amazing. The problem is that this is a jammed run, so jammed enemies take a lot.
On the upside, for rooms like this, it's kind of cool that you can just sort of fire it and it'll go through walls.
Exactly. Like, don't get me wrong, the Raiden Coil is amazing within its element. It's just, like, you can see how it's, like, freaking doing its mental gymnastics here. Raiden Coil is a very amazing weapon for room clearing. It is probably the best weapon for room clearing. But with jammed enemies, it becomes more of a problem. A lot more of a problem. So, let me ask you this. So, you know I have Table Tech Sight, right?
Yep.
And you know that Table Tech Sight increases your fired items by times 3, right?
It is.
How do you think that interacts with Raiden Coil?
Erotically.
It interacts amazingly. I don't think I realized that myself for a few minutes on this video, but it interacts exactly how you think it would. Instead of firing that single beam, it fires 3 beams. It's really good.
The world becomes lightning.
The world does become lightning. You know what? That's not good yet. So, the number of beams you fire out, it looks the same, for what that's worth. It's just that instead of firing one beam, which is going, you know, at the same plane, you fire 3 beams at the same plane, and they do 3 times the damage. Normally, Raiden Coil doesn't do much damage, but it's good. Is this a mimic? Yes.
Oh.
It's a jammed mimic. Damn it!
Oh,
every
frickin'
time!
Oh boy! Oh gosh! Throwing down with the devil's tool chest. Oh no!
The devil's tool chest. I like it. So one of my goals for this run is to unlock the Junkiest Boy, and because of all these frickin' mimics, it didn't happen.
Yeah. Sad day, because I do love my best little friend.
So it's somebody that we haven't seen in the LP yet. One day, I am definitely hoping to find the Junkiest Boy. But someday soon, not this video, but someday soon, we'll find him, and he's a very good boy.
I like to call him the Can's Necked.
Oh, man.
Aww.
He's a very good boy. I am so proud of him. I didn't encounter him at all on my 24-hour stream whenever I was there for it, but I have had a run with him, and he is the best boy. I will have a run with him, I swear to God. It will be great. And we will.
Oh, forsooth!
It will be. We will reach the ending screen, and he will pop up. He will pop up on it with us in the background. He is the best boy.
Oh yeah! What a small friend.
Like I keep dancing around it, but let's go ahead and admit it. So the supply drop update introduces a new item called Sir Junkin. Sir Junkin randomly appears as a piece of junk that you might encounter from a chest. So what Sir Junkin does is he pops up as a follower. He like follows you around the room, he helps out. But the real trick behind Sir Junkin is that the more pieces of junk you have, the stronger he gets.
Indeed, he's a little pile of garbage, but then that little pile of garbage realizes his destiny as a noble knight.
Sir Junkin is a little junk that could. So he starts off as a squire, then he turns into... Sir Junkin turns, eventually once you get enough junk, he turns into an angel knight. Sir Junkin turns into a massive damage doer. Sir Junkin is a good boy. So here's a special shrine, the anti-curse shrine. Depending on how much curse you have or how you have acquired it, this shrine can remove your curse. Since I am at 9 curse, the particular message I have is, tarry not, they come for you. If I was at 10 curse, it would say, well, you're kind of boned. Yeah, so this is a new enemy in the supply drop update. I'm not used to him yet.
There's a motherfucker.
Something like that. They confirm, that's it. They are a protogun piece. They shoot out tentacles of bullets. I don't like them. They shoot out lots of bullets.
They are a protogun piece.
That is even better. So, the shopkeeper is here. He has a key for us because there's the hip holster. That's what you were talking about.
Which is the best part.
Guess what I don't buy? It is. It's 98 casings.
Ooh. Yes!
It is. There are a few weapons that are one-shot weapons that are
okay.
Really good.
It's expensive.
In fact, there is one weapon.
It's expensive and it's really only good if you have one shot.
Wait, how much do you like the nail gun? Yeah, no, that's pretty much my response to the nail gun. The nail gun is a absolutely terrible weapon. Like, this is
one
of the weapons that the
Gunslinging
would challenge you to finish a room with. That's how bad the nail gun is. That's another one of the weapons the Gunslinging would challenge you to finish a room with. The nail gun's terrible.
I'd literally rather use the pea shooter.
No. So, I've encountered that challenge twice. One of them was on a normal run.
Call
me a
knave
if thou
must.
The other one was on a jammed run. And let me tell you ahead of time, if you have to deal with the nail gun on a jammed run, it's not going to go well. Well,
I think a jammed gun nut
sure
would suck up all
500
nails and not die.
Like, you're not wrong. You're just not wrong in the wrong way.
Oh, fair enough.
Yeah, you failed a challenge. Ask me how I found this out.
Yeah. So needless to say, if you run out of pepper before you clear the room, you fail the challenge. And then the Gunsling King calls you a chump.
So this is the first time I finally used the riding coil with table tech.
That's right. And then you come back once
you
found
the
guillotine gun.
You've got multiple beam shooting out. But, you know, with only a certain amount of enemies,
sick.
It's not too much you can do with it. But Raiden Coil is absolutely a room clearing item. This room. Instantly. Freaking done. Except for this one Jant enemy, because Jant enemies are the worst. I'm not sure if it stacks exactly, but I do know that I use both at once.
With table tech sights without shooting six beams.
That's the thing. Yeah, it's the small ones. Especially if you know, like, when you've got those... If you got the small poison globular
little ones, tiny
you can just shoot them into a pit instead. It's no big deal. Screw you, Red Mage. I hate Red Mages. The only thing I hate more than Red Mages is shock points.
So nice. Oh dear.
Are you a mimic? Yes.
Holy.
Are you a jammed mimic? Yes! Why wouldn't you be?
Yeah, that's right.
Jammed mimic.
Of course you are!
God. I might have found Sir Junkin, but I found so many jammed mimics instead.
Nice dodging.
Luckily it shot Nicola, which in addition to the ballistic boots.
Yeah, I mean
now I'm a very fast boy.
What one thing or another, I suppose.
I am extremely, extremely swift. especially if you have a map.
Hey.
Once you go through enough rooms, you can.
So I know exactly
what
boss.
Determine based on the room layout
down.
What sort of boss you might be fighting, like the last floor, or the floor with the beholster. I had a good idea of, based on this room layout, it's got to be either the Gorgon or the what's his name? What's his face? Beholster. Yes, that guy. And like I said, with the Gungeon blueprint, you always know what you're dealing with, or you always know what floor you're on. I should take a quick moment to talk about the jam demon faces. They're kind of chumps. I mean, they only shoot a couple bullets that are actually streamed at you. The rest of them are kind of random. Are you ready for jammed Wallmonger?
Yeah.
Luckily, with the sponge, I don't have to worry about fire.
Oh, boy. Well...
That's a thing.
Oh, son of a biscuit, I tell ya. What?
Oh. It's been a thing so far.
Jeez.
Especially because I have four blanks
as well.
Hey there,
the theme of
this
LP, aka Scruffy negating the Wallmonger's second phase.
With me being able to completely negate the fire trench, that is a... It's absolutely useful with the explosions from the stinger erasing bullets once in a while. Also extremely useful. So did I mention that most of the time, all the floor 4 bosses I have trouble getting the master round on?
Perfect. Nice.
So we got the master unlocking as the item, which is play well, get keys. It's like the heart synthesizer, the ammo synthesizer. And the armor synthesizer, but it's for keys instead. And Master of Unlocking, by the way, because it's a beret, is a reference to Resident Evil. Because Jill Valentine is the Master of Unlocking.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, there are no Jill sandwiches to be had in this game.
That's right.
Alas.
Barry's not going to sit there taking the lockpicks. Well, maybe if you take
maybe.
Too long on the Wallmonger.
So I've heard, I have not encountered this myself, if you take too long on the Wallmonger, he can actually crush you against the bottom wall.
I mean, it's never happened for me, because I know...
Yeah, it hasn't happened for me either, but I hear it's a thing.
One way or the other, for me, the Wallmonger's always open very quickly.
So the first two supply drop runs I did... I died to the Wallmonger twice. Once was on a normal run, the other time was on a challenge run. And gee whiz, I cannot wait to encounter challenge runs.
Oh, yes.
I will tell you now, I have not yet completed a challenge run. I've gotten to the Hyatt Dragon once on a challenge run. It's freaking tough.
Yeah, I had a hard enough time with the Blessing of the Gun Runs.
Yeah, no, Blessing of the Gun Runs is... Like, now look at it like, holy shit, just a Blessing of the Gun? That's easy. What do you get? What are you talking about?
Oh, yeah.
Now my mess is freaking challenge runs. Let me freaking tell you.
Oh, gosh. Damn you, Icosahedrax.
Yeah, Icosahedrax is the actual worst. Oh, man. Yeah, so the bane of my existence on the previous run, before this one that you haven't seen yet, is actually these shroomers. Like, you wouldn't think they're such a big deal, because they shoot around you. If you don't move, you don't have a problem.
I tell you, man, but... you're like a chess master facing off against a rookie. You just have no idea how to deal with their ineptitude.
It's funny you mention that. Because every time I play chess with somebody, usually I wind up playing against somebody who knows what they're doing.
Mm.
And every freaking time that I play chess, it's with somebody who goes, I can't tell what you're doing, but you're doing it in exactly the way that would counter what I want to do. Like, I wish I wasn't exactly doing it that way. It just happens to be how I play chess. Like, I just happen to be the counter player by accident.
You're the hard counter to actual skill.
Exactly. I play the short game, and unfortunately for everybody I play against, the short game is against their long games.
I don't know what the problem is. I'm just moving entirely at random.
But that's just it. It's not entirely at random. I'm playing the game based on what I see.
Mm.
The problem is that some people have long-term plans for what they see. I just have, look, here's what's happening in the game as I see it. Let's deal with this. So let's see what's here in the shop. The Molotov Launcher is garbage. The Super Soaker is also super garbage. The only thing worth picking up is the Heck Blaster.
I think you'll find that the Heck Blaster is entirely groovy.
I will definitely find the Heck Blaster is entirely groovy.
It's groovy!
Groovy!
That's right.
So I'm actually kind of happy to see this room because most of these gun cultists, normally they'd be gigantic jerks, most of the time they fall into the pit of their own accord.
Yeah, they do the really good Dark Souls PvP thing where they just panic roll.
Pretty much. I really don't like these blue wisps.
Ooh, yep. You don't
this is
close.
A bad room. I took like 2 hits and took a hard amount of damage. Yeah. And this is the danger of jammed runs, is that you encounter jammed enemies at random, and they just do a lot of damage that you just... Like, if they were normal enemies, you might be okay with it, but with them being jammed, it's just so much worse.
They play this beautiful psychological game where it's like, oh no, I get hit by a jammed enemy, I might as well roll over and die now.
I can see this is a jammed wisp, like, I just hate seeing jammed enemies. There's a specific item introduced in the Supply Drop update called Silver Bullets. According to its description, it massively increases damage against jammed enemies, and also somewhat increases damage against bosses.
It's pretty nice, man. A sling with silver bullets. Oh, I tell ya.
I could imagine that being sort of a boss killer by itself. That sounds pretty amazing.
I mean, if you can bank a silver sling shot off the wall, it's amazing. Holy shit, I just looked up the stats. Silver bullets increases damage to jammed enemies by 225%. Oh, man,
that makes me really sad that I haven't unlocked jammed
silver
bullets on this LP yet.
If you use the Blunderbuss Crossbow Dueling Pistol or Trick Gun, that does an extra 50% damage to jammed enemies for a total of 487.5%. That is like muscle relaxant levels of good. Oh, small friend!
Yes, do you see the caped friend?
I do see the small friend.
Do you see who I'm not going to kill in this room?
Good for you.
That will, so by the way, caped friend... This puts us at 4 out of 5.
Aw, yeah, little cutie.
So, I don't know if he's getting buffed with the supply drop or what. But, little friend just... I can't quite put my finger on it, but I'm better with him than I was before supply drop.
Hmm.
Red chest, hello.
Oh, heart. Yeah, wow, well, you already spoiled
this. It's not breathing. So, yes.
Oh.
Dragonfire.
Oh, hello. You're adequate, Dragonfire. You're an adequate gun.
Dragonfire is definitely an adequate gun. That's a good description for a red chest item. It's adequate. It's not amazing.
It's not shit it's hot. Not,
no, it, and that's just it. It's not great. Like, Dragonfire's okay. But it's also... It's really not bad for what it is. And that's... It's kind of damning it with faint praise. Does that make sense?
Yeah, sure. I'll go with that.
Like, Dragonfire, for what it is, like a red chest weapon, should be a better weapon. Like, if anything, I'd put Dragonfire in a green chest.
Yeah, you know, it's just, in terms of effectiveness, personally, I'd rather have the AK.
Yeah, you know, honestly, the AK-47, I think, is a brown chest item. I would easily upgrade it to a
green
chest item.
It's green.
It's green, at least. Like, yep. I would give it to... I would definitely give it a blue.
I believe the AK is actually...
I want to say it's brown.
It's quality B. Quality B. So it's a green chest.
Is it?
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah.
That makes sense. Yep. Yeah, no.
Otherwise, I'd be opening brown chests forever.
That's one of the things, is like... One of the challenges I've seen, one of the things I plan on doing is a brown chest challenge.
Oh, so
at some point.
So you thought you were going to get nice and easy. Find an AK, just be like, oh yeah, this brown chest run. Wow, I'm so hobbled.
Yeah, no. I plan on doing a brown chest run at some point. And probably what I'm going to wind up encountering is just the lowercase letter R over and over again. The worst gun in the game. Mm. No. I'm gonna have the lowercase letter R, I'm gonna have the club, and I'm gonna have the pea shooter.
Hey, I mean, at least the club's got some synergy.
Nothing going for it.
Well, it's just got a... Wait, oh no, it's got a negative synergy, never mind.
The club is a bad gun, just saying.
It sucks.
It's one of those guns the Gunsling King will challenge you to finish your run with.
And if the Gunsling King likes it...
If the Gunsling King challenges you to finish a room with it, it's a bad sign.
Don't use it. Or maybe use it and then post YouTube videos and get all the fame and free cheeseburger sponsorships that you could enjoy.
I will receive all of the likes. Every
so
single one.
Many thumbs. So get in the hole, you bastard!
I don't know what it is. Apparently there's like one person who dislikes like most of the videos I make.
Yeah, I don't know if they're just hoping that Senpai notices them and they'll be like super happy now that you've mentioned it.
I'm pretty sure I know who it is. And apparently he really does not like Kalon Zombie or Great Joe's commentators.
Wow, bummer. I hope you like me, motherfucker. Otherwise, I'm coming back.
I'm looking forward to this Kippy bump.
Yeah, no. Nice. Who do you think I am? I'm trash.
Oh, goodness. Here's two jammed snipers. This is the worst. In addition to a Killathid. Also makes me freaking sad.
We're like Dillathid, right?
Let's not get too saucy.
You're right, I'm sorry. I should be nicer to Squid Americans.
So at this point I realize, wait a minute, Raiden called us shit for damage.
Yep.
Let's bring out the Winchester rifle, which is a brown chest weapon. Definitely not something I should be using on the fourth floor or fifth floor, but here we are.
It's not the worst brown chest weapon in the world, but
it's close.
I mean, it kind of
look
really
at all
was.
These freaking bullets. I had to dodge into a pit just to dodge bullets.
Oh gosh.
Look at all these mages. Look at this red mage. I hate all of this room.
Gosh, man. I really apologize for bringing up stuff that we haven't seen yet, but there's one weapon that, and I'm gonna just say it shoots
spit
sharks.
It out, just do it.
All right, it's
yes.
It shoots sharks, and it turns out that those red wizards can steal your sharks.
Yeah, I think the shark weapon is a reference to the game Armed and Dangerous.
It's gotta be.
I'm pretty sure it is, because that game said we had a shark launcher.
Oh, it 100%. God, that game was funny.
Yeah, no, it's one of those things, like, I played the demo and I'm like, maybe I should play this game for real. And then I didn't.
Yeah, then you're like, wait a minute, this is the worst British humor I've ever seen.
It wasn't the worst, I've seen worse.
That's true.
Let's be fair, I'm involved in worse at this point.
That's right, man. Well, look, it's as a first generation Canadian and the son of British immigrants, I can tell you that British comedy boils down to two things: cross-dressing and gay panic.
Hey, that's fine. I own the entirety of Monty Python's Flying Circus on DVD.
Oh heck yes.
I get it for better than that. I get it for cheap. I get on sale.
Oh, that's Scottish of you.
even worse, I haven't even watched all of it yet.
As long as you've seen the good stuff. I mean, my favorite British comedy show of all time is Allo Allo, and boy, the amount of time they spend studiously not exposing their backside to Lieutenant Gruber. Boy howdy. Hey.
So one of these things I should mention, the item I just picked up from the chest, the Gun Knight's armor.
Yep.
There are three pieces of Gun Knight's armor. There's like the Gun Knight's greaves, the Gun Knight's helmet, and the Gun Knight's breastplate, whatever it is.
Yeah, there's three available at first, and you got to unlock the fourth through the hunting quests.
I don't know if there's a fourth one, but
helmet.
If you, you're right, there's a helmet. If you own all of them at the same time, you encounter a transformation event where you turn into Cormorant, the Aimless Knight. I have not done this yet, either in my main playthroughs or at all. The specific benefit of Cormorant is you no longer have to reload.
Yeah. You also get Hella Cursed.
You also get Hella Cursed, that's the thing. But maybe I will encounter that for the LP. I don't know. I know that once you encounter one item, you're more likely to encounter the rest.
Yeah.
Kind of like spice, but different.
You gotta get you gotta get lucky on an early floor, basically.
Yeah. If you encounter it on an early floor, you're more likely to encounter it. But you never know. We'll see. I might become Cormorant the Aimless Knight. We'll see. I haven't done it yet. Like I said, I haven't done it on my main playthroughs. There's still an option. So you remember how I said if I didn't take that one hit on Ken and Balrog, I would have had all five master rounds?
Oh man, are we about to see a masterclass in Dragon Slaying?
We're about to see a masterclass in Dragon Slaying. I mean, it's not a jammed dragon, so maybe it doesn't matter, but it still makes me feel really bad. I'm pretty sure this is at least the third time that I've gotten four out of five master rounds in a single run.
It's don't let perfect be the enemy of the good, I suppose.
Yeah, no, don't get me wrong, it's still a good run. It's just, especially for a curse run. Like, you have to consider what I've dealt with getting here. All these freaking cursed mimics.
Oh man. So many cursed mimics.
Every single mimic. Like maybe one of them out of five was not cursed. They are the worst.
Oh, we love you, Heckblaster.
Yeah, so that's one of the reasons I'm using Heckblaster, is those skulls he fires out can be destroyed.
It's got like 1,000 shots in its hit scan. It's really nice.
It is. It's really good. I can't wait until I try and do a challenge mode run DLP. I can't wait, and the reason for that is because I still haven't finished a normal, like, on my main file, I still have not finished a challenge mode run because I keep dying. Because challenge mode is the worst. Oh my god, I can't wait.
There's no such thing as comfort or success in challenge mode.
Yeah, no, challenge mode, like, apparently the plan for the game is to eventually add more beneficial chances challenge mode. Right now they're all bad.
Oh,
they
yeah.
are all bad.
It's a straight up challenge.
It's like, don't get me wrong, as a person who is good at this game, which I don't feel bad at, like, defining myself that way. I feel like I'm pretty good at this game. Challenge mode I have not completed once. It's really freaking tough. Like, normally I'd hesitate to call myself, you know, like a talented person at this game, but I just got 4 out of 5 master rounds on jammed mode, so.
Heck yeah, that was against a couple of jammed bosses, I think.
So we had Smiles and Shades.
Yep.
We had the poster was normal.
Yep.
Cannonball Rug was jammed. I took a hit against him.
Yeah, but that's just because Cannonball Rug's trash.
A jerk. Jammed Wallmonger.
Yep.
Got the master round against him. Oh yeah, here's another achievement. If you manage to fall off at the very end, you get an achievement called Lion Leap. Just gee whiz.
Yep. I like the icon for that. But I also like Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade.
So my plan for tomorrow, by the way, President's Day, I have off just for gee whiz.
Mm-hmm.
My plan is to watch all the Indiana Jones movies.
So good. That's my go-to sick day thing.
Like, my sick day thing previously was The Princess Bride, because that always cheers me up.
Very nice.
So because I have the Gungeon blueprint, I can see how this floor is laid out. And let me tell you, it's extremely inconvenient. I have to go down, then left, then up to get to the frickin' boss.
Holy crust, you're right.
This is the frickin' worst layout. Luckily, Raiden Coil's here to save me from at least partially myself.
Oh man, there's nothing I hate more than jammed poop.
Jammed poop is the freaking worst.
You really gotta eat more grapes, man.
You know, what can I say? I just got a little bit of issues with my regularity.
It's that high protein diet.
I haven't been eating my grape nuts.
Oh, thank you so much for bringing me on to the episode where I could be crass. Oh, it feels good. It's my style.
Yes. So this is what I consider the end of a jam run, is finishing Bullet Hell. Like, if you just consider finishing a jam run being killing the dragon, then hey, you know, I'm there. But, you know what? I can do better than that.
Yeah, you gotta aim high.
Aim high. Aim for the stars. That way, everybody watching you knows you're not even freaking trying to aim for the target. That's my life motto.
Yeah, that's great. That's great. Aim for the stars, because if you fuck up, at least you can say, well, it's not like you chumps could do any better.
So yeah, jam spectral gun nuts, they're jerks. Not only do they shoot out the one jammed bullet, every single bullet they shoot out is jammed, and the jammed bullets also. Look at all this freaking damage I'm taking with all my armor. It's the worst.
Oh no! And you got to deal with these angry jammed gloopies.
Yeah, the jammed gloopies, these guys are like not the worst, because they can only hurt you so much. Like, the only particular damage they can do to you if you keep moving, like, eventually they explode. Otherwise, these guys are not that bad.
They don't look like other jammed gloopies, which tend to move a little bit faster, too.
They really don't. Like, I think they move at the same normal speed.
What's the deal, Enter the Gungeon? Why are you being so chill?
I don't know. But Gungeon and Robot, hashtag no chill.
Yeah, that's right. Just Dark Souls things. Punishing ignorance.
Hashtag just chill things.
Aw, so chill.
So even though there were no jammed enemies in this room, I still took damage.
Welcome
and
to
here's board. A room that's full of mages.
Oh. I hate these
Even
nerds.
Better. It starts off with yellow mages, it goes to purples, and it goes to blues, and it goes to reds. Let me tell you how much I love this room. Let me tell you how much I love frickin' wizards.
Oh, it's so gruesome.
I'm going to mail them. Documentary on how much I love these assholes.
That's right. Mail that guy a 5th edition supplement and punches to the neck.
Oh, I'll give him a supplement.
Yeah, that's right. These guys are gonna need you to walk over them with the sponge once you're through with them.
So that's one of the reasons that I really enjoy the Raiden Coils at the Red Mages. If you have any sort of weapon that's like either a hit scan or a beam weapon, they can't do anything about it.
At least the bullets they suck up don't also become jammed, so.
And I'm actually not sure about that.
Yeah, it looked like they were shooting regular bullets out of their little aura.
Yeah, but I also wasn't giving them any bullets to shoot back.
Oh, good point. Oh, well, I'm gonna have nightmares about jammed sharks now.
Let me frickin' tell you about how the rest of this floor goes. Maybe you're aware of how bullet hell goes, especially when it's full of jammed enemies.
It's...
especially when you see here, I've got a jammed pupillon going on in the top right corner. In addition to all the frickin' gun cultists flying around.
Gosh, Aruni. Yeah, these runes are... Come on!
Do you see this? That frickin' roller normally would kill this enemy, but because it's jammed, it has enough health to survive a hit, so it comes frickin' flying at me.
Fired directly up your face. That's great. Thanks, bullet hell.
And then, this particular room seems to always have one lead maiden, and two what do they call them? Skullets? Yes, skullets.
Yeah. And these fallen bulletkin. I got one of my pals to tweet at the devs that these guys should have been called shell spawn. It's a missed opportunity.
Nice.
Shell
I
spawn,
like it.
Man. Please, everyone, start referring to them as such. It's very important. My legacy.
I can't guarantee I'm gonna always revert to that way. But it's you're not wrong. That's a very good way to do it. Shell spun. I love it.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm very gratified.
I'm gonna try. I really love it. I really love shell spun. That's a great way to refer to it. Yeah, because you see, the one with the red mages, if you just fire them normally, they will absorb your bullets. Oh, look at that.
Ugh.
A jammed freaking shot grub. My freaking favorite.
Yeah, Shark Nightmare has been superseded now.
A room. So you know that one room where you like normally you have to deal with like one gun knight in the middle, and then it spawns four shot grubs on all corners of the room?
Yeah.
Imagine if they're all jammed.
Ugh. Oh, so many jam bullets.
That is my freaking nightmare. That is my bullet hell. Like, at this point, I'm kind of hoping I find the blooper just so I can, like, fire enemies into the pits. Oh,
Oh.
If I'm not mistaken, this room is the one that pretty much murders me.
Oh, this is sick. Oh, this is... Ban this sick filth!
Because you have this... This is a blue Amomancer.
Yep.
Who buffs all the enemies in the room as long as it's not being attacked. And he's jammed, so as soon as I do contact damage, I take a heart of damage.
Yeah.
This is going so well.
Oh, gruesome! Oh.
I had to blank that or else I was pretty much gonna die.
Gotta do it. There's no excuse for dying with blanks in your pocket. That's...
Pretty much. Well, good news as far as that goes. I don't die with any unused blanks, I'll tell you that much.
Yep. There's,
So here's a veteran shotgun Ken, a blue and a red shotgun Ken. They've got pretty much everything but the ashen shotgun Ken represented.
Oh!
Also a jammed one for Gee Whiz.
Sure. Bullets every day. Oh, man.
Dirt is hometown, bullets are life.
Pucker factor is high, man. I'm not gonna lie.
Hey, have a heart.
Oh.
It's looking good.
So close.
Unfortunately, I don't have enough blanks to get to that secret room with the red launcher.
Yep.
So I finally unlocked the. I got the Gunslinger's Ashes.
Yep.
From that point onwards, any further times you encounter the Red Muncher, you have to feed it a random number of guns. After you feed it the whatever the specified number is, that random number, it will give you a random S gun, a random black tier gun.
Yeah.
So if you make it down to bullet hell and you can find the Red Muncher, and you have guns to give away like I do, like the Winchester rifle and all the other crap I've got.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, hey, look, got stuck on geometry again.
Yep, that'll happen.
Like, if I made it to the gun, if I made it to the Red Muncher, this run might have turned out good.
Might have ended up with something cool, like, I don't know, railgun, maybe.
Yeah, hey. You know, not Casey, but Casey's a brown chest item, which I feel like is a mistake. I gotta be honest with you. Like, I can't wait until I unlock Casey. Casey's a.
I think the reason is that every right-thinking human being agrees with me, Skippy Granola, that it's just too risky to be worth it.
But if you get cocky. And you get sassy, and you're willing to engage in melee combat? Ooh, it does so much damage.
If you're willing to enter the Gungeon and use a baseball bat like a savage.
Yeah, no, you're right. As a right-thinking person, bringing a baseball bat to a gunfight sounds like a terrible idea.
Unless
I'm
you're Kazuma Kiryu.
So let me see here. I've got one half heart.
Half a heart.
And I'm about to fight the Lich.
Like trash tier guns. Okay, let's see how this goes.
You think I think you got a chance?
Oh yeah, sure. You're gonna sweep the leg.
Luckily he's not jammed yet.
Yeah. In this phase.
In this phase. Every phase of the Lich has a chance of being jammed, by the way. That's a thing.
That was Tombstoner.
You can see the enemies.
Though.
You can see the enemies he summons can also be jammed. Because I hate myself.
Holy jeez. You are really hanging in there.
Oh, give it time.
Oh boy. Gosh.
There it is.
Oh, hello. That's a hard one to dodge.
Yeah. So there's about 20 seconds left. Any last thoughts?
That was really cool, man. I was happy to see how the sausage is made.
An hour and 12 minutes for nothing.
Four deaths. Bummer.
Until next time, aim true.
Keep your powder dry.